This is a podcast of the Nuffield Department of Medicine. Today we are asking Professor Joel Tarning about his research in malaria treatment. Hi, Joel.
Hi.
Why is it important to get the dosage of antimalarial drugs right?
Malaria is one of the most important parasitic diseases in the world, and we need to treat patients with malaria drugs in order to kill all the parasites in the body. If the patient receives a dose that is too high, you can have adverse reactions and toxicity which might harm the patient. And if they instead get a dose that is too low, we don't kill all the parasites in the body. And these remaining parasites can grow back and cause new infections, which will result in unnecessary suffering and, in the worst case scenario, death. And if a patient, if a parasite survives the treatment, it also has a chance to sample the drug, and it could then develop drug resistance. So it's absolutely crucial that we give all patients the correct doses in order to cure the disease by killing all the parasites in the body, and therefore also minimize the risk of resistance development.
So how do you get the dosage of the antimalarial drug right?
Well, to determine the correct dose, we need to do and conduct clinical studies in sick patients. So we enroll malaria patients and treat them with a malaria drug. We then take blood samples from these patients over the treatment course, and we measure the amount of drug in these samples. And we do that in order to try to understand how these drugs behave in the body. So, for example, I want to know how fast the drug is absorbed into the bloodstream. Mm-hmm. I want to know how the drug is distributed in the body and how fast the drug is eliminated from the body. And some of these processes can be different between young children and adult patients. And only by understanding how these processes work and the differences between patients, then we can understand how to treat these patients correctly and to determine the correct dose in order to give all patients an equal chance of being cured.
How has this line of research changed malaria treatments?
My work has shown that that young children need a higher malaria dose of two commonly used malaria drugs. And this was recently picked up by the World Health Organization, and in the new recently published antimalarial treatment guidelines, we recommend a higher dosage for these two drugs. I've shown that we have similar trends in young children and pregnant women for other drugs, but we need more studies in order to determine the correct doses for these drugs and also these patients. We also studied how to treat drug-resistant malaria, and these infections are very difficult to treat, and one option would be to use several malaria drugs in order to treat these difficult infections.
What are the most important lines of research that have emerged in the last 5 to 10 years?
I believe that the identification and the characterization of artemisinin-resistant malaria is the most important recent development. Artemisinin is the first-line therapy that we use for malaria today, and a worldwide resistance to this drug will be catastrophic, since we have no alternative drugs to treat this disease if this drug fails. And we recently mapped the resistance development, and it is now appearing in Myanmar, closing and moving towards India. And of course, if this movement continues through Africa, where 85% of all the malaria infections occur, that'll be a very, very severe situation. So I think that this is the single greatest threat that we have today towards treating and controlling malaria.
Why is your work important? So why should people pay for this work and for this research to be done?
Well, half of the world's population is at risk of getting malaria. And last year it was about 200 million cases. So that's more malaria cases than if everyone in the UK will get malaria 3 times during the next year. So I think it's absolutely crucial that we determine the correct doses for antimalarial drugs. And malaria also kills about 2,000 people every day. And most of these are young children under the age of 5. So it's very crucial that we treat all patients correctly, and especially children who bear the highest burden of death due to malaria. And my research aims to try to determine the correct doses for these vulnerable populations, such as children and pregnant women.
How does your work fit within translational medicine within the department?
I work closely with other scientists within the department and outside the department to collect the necessary blood samples in these clinical studies. My lab then measures the amount of drug in these samples to identify how much drug these patients have in their system. And I use this information together with mathematical and statistical modeling techniques to understand how these drugs behave in the body and in different patients. So for example, to understand how does age affect the drug, or how does pregnancy affect the drug, and what is the effect on the treatment response due to that. So I think that this is truly a translational approach, because we can combine data from many different disciplines in order to maximize the information that we can achieve from a clinical study. So in short, my research translates drug measurements into new dose regimens, and I hope that that will create a better treatment for patients with malaria.
Thank you, Joel. That's great.
Thank you.